Initiating Mars drive in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mars drive is online.
Well, it was about time.
Let me show you my workflow for how I did this AI ad for Project Odyssey 2 competition. From the beginning, I knew that I wanted to create a car-related project, and I had two options. Go all in on fantasy concept or present a car that does not exist yet. Using AI, creating a completely fictional vehicle would have been easy. However, it would also allow me to cover up imperfections since there is no real-world reference for how a levitating organic nanotechnology car should look or behave, and I didn't want to take that route. Instead, I chose a more realistic approach. I decided to work on a product people could actually judge and compare. The scenes and story I planned weren't overly futuristic, just slightly ahead of their time. This felt more challenging and rewarding. While brainstorming, I had recently watched The Martian with Matt Damon. That sealed the decision to set the project on Mars. Next question was, what present-day car could adapt to such an extreme environment? After considering a few options, the Cybertruck stood out as the best fit. With that, I had my starting point. The idea and story came to me quickly. Surprisingly, I knew exactly what to do. I only used ChatGPT to refine the concept and polish the narrative. Next, I had to figure out how to maintain object consistency. Training a model was an option, but I didn't have enough high-quality reference images, nor did I have time to gather them, so I purchased a simple Cybertruck 3D model for about $5 to use as a reference. The only modifications I made were adding metallic rims to the rear for more visual interest and slightly widening the wheels. Otherwise, I kept it true to the original design. For image generation, I first developed the visual look, including color grading and style, and once I had that foundation, I created basic 3D renders of the car and uploaded them to the MidJourney editor. I retextured these renders repeatedly, ensuring a consistent style and design. This approach gave me more control than I expected. For the opening scenes without car, I was writing prompts directly in the MidJourney. With the images ready, I moved on to the video creation. I used combination of mostly Kling and Runway for different scenes. Over time, I developed an instinct for which tools work better for specific shots. It wasn't a one and done process. I had to tweak and steer the outputs repeatedly until I achieved the desired result. Once all scenes were ready, I upscaled them to 4K resolution and 30 FPS using Topaz video, which is my go-to for this purpose. To add sound, I processed all videos through audio for basic effects. For scenes requiring lip sync, I used Kling.
5, 4.
The audio for that came from 11 labs, and finding the right voices took the most time. But the generation process was simple. One trick for you, to add emotional diversity to AI-generated voices, I used a trick of inserting cues into the script. For example, writing "And he was really excited and said." Then you will paste your script. That prompted the tool to deliver the line with more energy. With the audio and video complete, I moved to editing in Premiere Pro and After Effects. While I could have added more post-production in After Effects, I chose to let the AI outputs take center stage. I only made a few clean edits where necessary. And here's a lesson for everyone. Always read the brief carefully. Because I initially edited a 1.5 minute ad, only to realize that there was 1 minute limit. So cutting it down wasted some time, but I managed. I also cut the music to end on a beat, ensuring the track felt cohesive despite that time restriction. And for the ending, I used one of my favorite tricks in Runway, which is using camera control. I created horizontal movements and a zoom from the same image, upscaled it, and interpolated the frames to slow the motion by 2x. This gave me enough frames to smooth out the camera movement using timer mapping, otherwise it would be linear and it would look bad. The final result is a project that I am quite proud of. It's not perfect, but I think it's good. By focusing on storytelling and adhering to fundamental editing principles, I created an ad that feels cohesive and polished, rather than just a collection of random AI-generated clips. Hopefully this inspires you to explore some of these techniques in your own projects, and stay tuned for more updates.
Mission control to Explorer 1. Final system checks are complete. Initiating Mars Drive in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mars Drive is online.
Well, it was about time.
On Mars, every challenge is magnified. That's why we built the Tesla Cybertruck, Mars Edition. It adapts, evolves, and excels, no matter the terrain. From electric pioneers to frontier explorers, the future begins here. Built for Earth, perfect for Mars.